Give God the glory. Give Him the praise.
Oh, Let us say, Amen for the word of God for us.
Jesus is worthy of praise.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Let us say,
Praise the Lord.
Give him praise.
Amen.
Let us say,
Thank you, Jesus.
Praise the Lord.
Amen.
Sing a song of deliverance.
After the children of Israel had fled Egypt and camped between two mountains, facing the Red Sea, with the living God leading them through signs and wonders, like a cloud over them during the day and a fire over them in the night time, they were attacked from the rear by 600 Egyptian captains in their chariots, and God opened the Red Sea, and more than 2 million people crossed over on dry land, as God interceded for them in the rear. Then the Egyptians attempted to overtake them in the midst of the Red Sea on dry land, and God caused the Red Sea to return to its borders, and the Egyptian forces were drowned in the Red Sea.
Well, Moses, the man who had at one time stuttered, now lifted his voice and gave personal testimony in song, using personal nouns. From the fruit of his heart, Moses sang for himself because he had been delivered. It was a personal deliverance song that he sang from his heart for the personal deliverance that God had done for him personally.
And the men of Israel, realizing that it was a personal song of deliverance, sang the words too.
Exodus 15:1. Then Moses and the Israelites sang this song to the Lord.
I will sing to the Lord, for he is highly exalted. The horse and its rider, he has hurled into the sea. Exodus 15:2.
The Lord is my strength and my song. He has become my salvation. He is my God, and I will praise him. My father's God, and I will exalt him. Exodus 15:3.
The Lord is a warrior. The Lord is his name. Exodus 15:4.
Pharaoh's chariots and his army, he has hurled into the sea. The best of Pharaoh's officers are drowned in the Red Sea. Exodus 15:5.
The deep waters have covered them. They sank to the depths like a stone. Exodus 15:6.
Your right hand, O Lord, was majestic in power. Your right hand, O Lord, shattered the enemy. Exodus 15:7.
In the greatness of your majesty, you threw down those who opposed you. You unleashed your burning anger. It consumed them like stubble. Exodus 15:8.
By the blast of your nostrils, the waters piled up. The surging waters stood firm like a wall. The deep waters congealed in the heart of the sea. Exodus 15:9.
The enemy boasted, I will pursue, I will overtake them. I will divide the spoils. I will gorge myself on them. I will draw my sword, and my hand will destroy them. Exodus 15:10.
But you blew with your breath, and the sea covered them. They sank like lead in the mighty waters. Exodus 15:11.
Who among the gods is like you, O Lord? Who is like you? Majestic in holiness, awesome in glory, working wonders.
The God of Israel is unique, and he challenged Pharaoh and his kingdom by demonstrating his powerful reality to them with plagues and signs and wonders.
The Lord showed them how foolish they were to worship, sacrifice, and trust in their imaginary idol gods.
For 430 years, the God of Israel had been with the children of Israel in the land of Egypt, showing the Egyptians how they could be blessed if they had worshipped him like the children of Israel, who were blessed even in bondage and multiplied in their land.
The Egyptians refused to realize that their blessings they received and attributed to their idol gods
were actually overflow blessings caused by the children of Israel worshipping their one and only true living God while they were in Egypt.
The Egyptians liked and desired God's blessings like many of us do today.
But they did not like the people of God,
his chosen vessels,
that were the cause of the blessings.
Nor did they want to acknowledge
his chosen people's Lord
as sovereign over them and superior to their imagined false idol gods,
like many people today. Exodus 15:12.
You stretched out your right hand, and the earth swallowed them.
The wages of the spiritually righteous is eternal life, but the wages of the spiritually wicked is death, judgment, and the eternal fire of hell, as punishment.
Romans 6:23. For the wages of sin is death, but the gift of God is eternal life through Jesus Christ our Lord.
Moses, already under the inspiration of the Lord,
begin to sing in song, good news prophecy,
to the children of Israel,
who had just passed over the Red Sea,
to encourage them, to journey on, to the land, promised to them,
by the God of Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob. Exodus 15:13.
In your unfailing love you will lead the people you have redeemed. In your strength you will guide them to your holy dwelling. Colossians 1:13 and 14. For he has rescued us from the dominion of darkness and brought us into the kingdom of the Son he loves, in whom we have redemption, the forgiveness of sins. Exodus 15:14.
The nations will hear and tremble. Anguish will grip the people of Philistia.
Isaiah 33:13 and 14.
Hear, ye that are far off, what I have done, and, ye that are near, acknowledge my might.
The sinners in Zion are afraid, fearfulness hath surprised the hypocrites.
Who among us shall dwell with the devouring fire?
Who among us shall dwell with everlasting burnings?
Isaiah 33:15. He that walks righteously, and speaks uprightly, he that despises the gain of oppressors, that keeps his hands from accepting bribes, that stops his ears from hearing of bloodlust, and shuts his eyes from seeing evil. Exodus 15:15.
The chiefs of Edom will be terrified. The leaders of Moab will be seized with trembling. The people of Canaan will melt away. Numbers 14:14.
And they will tell it to the inhabitants of this land.
For they have heard that thou, Lord,
art among this people,
that thou, Lord,
art seen face to face,
and that thy cloud
standeth over them,
and that thou goest
before them
by daytime
in a pillar of a cloud,
and in a pillar of fire
by night. Exodus 15:16.
Terror and dread will fall upon them by the power of your arm. They will be as still as a stone until your people pass by, O Lord. Until the people you bought pass by. Exodus 15:17.
You will bring them in and plant them on the mountain of your inheritance, the place, O Lord, you made for your dwelling, the sanctuary, O Lord, your hands established.
Psalms 2:6. Yet have I set my king upon my holy hill of Zion.
Revelation 14:1. And I looked, and, lo, a lamb stood on the Mount Zion, and with him 144,000.
Having his father's name written in their foreheads. Exodus 15:18.
The Lord will reign, forever and ever.
The King of Kings, the Lord Jesus, the Son of God, will reign over his kingdom on earth, from the city called New Jerusalem, on the Mount of Zion, in the Millennium Kingdom, forever.
Matthew 5:5. Blessed are the meek, for they shall inherit the earth.
Moses began to highlight to the children of Israel the evidence that they had just witnessed, pointing out that this evidence assures them that the Lord their God will clear for them a safe passage around or through the lands of their adversaries. They were a nation now of 2 or 3 million, traveling without an army to protect them, to a land already occupied, but promised to them by the Lord, in whom they had put their trust in. Exodus 15:19.
When Pharaoh's horses, chariots and horsemen went into the sea, the Lord brought the waters of the sea back over them, but the Israelites walked through the sea on dry ground.
Why is the song of Moses so powerful and astonishing to us today?
Is it because it is the first recorded song in the Bible?
Is it because it is the song that the saints of God will sing in heaven?
Is it because it is the first time that the Lord God of Israel used signs and wonders for all to see?
The living God of Israel, the creator of the universe, appeared visible as a sign and wonder that he was not only the God of Israel, but he was visibly presiding over the affairs of the children of Israel.
The Lord God Jehovah, in the sight of the children of Israel, proved to them, through his powerful works, that he not only loved them, but that he was capable to defend his children, his elect, his peculiar people, from all of their enemies, if they simply obeyed him.
The Lord God of Israel had instructed them, step by step,
during the deliverance, and they had obeyed the Lord. They saw God's deliverance with their own eyes, and so did Pharaoh and his people.
Father God is loving and merciful, but no one should come against the children of God.
Those who would oppose the chosen nation of the Lord God Jehovah and his elect children of God will be severely punished.
If they continue to impede his children's quest to return to their Father Creator and Lord of the universe,
they are his dear children, called by his name.
The Lord God's mighty power and his defense of his elect children became widely known throughout the land as they traveled to the promised land. God's fame and the signs and wonders in the night sky and daylight drove many neighboring lands that would have opposed a nation of 2+ million people moving around and near their borders to fear the God of Israel and to appease his people as much as possible while they passed on their way to the promised land.
The Song of Miriam, the prophetess, the older sister of Moses, who did not grow up with Moses in the house of Pharaoh like Moses did,
was also faithful to the Lord like Moses. She began to dance and sang and play the tambourine before the Lord because it was personal.
She had been delivered like the men and the children and the babies and the strangers that came with the children of Israel out of Egypt.
And the women, grateful for the greatness and mercy of the Lord God of Israel, joined in and sang the chorus to the song of Moses and danced before the Lord.
Hallelujah. Exodus 15:20.
Then Miriam the prophetess, Aaron's sister, took a tambourine in her hand, and all the women followed her with tambourines and dancing.
Hallelujah. Exodus 15:21.
Miriam sang to them,
"Sing to the Lord, for he is highly exalted. The horse and its rider, he has hurled into the sea."
Hallelujah. Exodus 15:1.
"I will sing to the Lord, for he is highly exalted. The horse and its rider, he has hurled into the sea."
Hallelujah. Exodus 15:21.
"Sing to the Lord, for he is highly exalted. The horse and its rider, he has hurled into the sea."
Hallelujah. Exodus 15:1.
"I will sing to the Lord, for he is highly exalted. The horse and its rider, he has hurled into the sea."
The children of Israel had been sighing because of their bondage in Egypt, and their Father in heaven, the Lord God Almighty, heard them.
Exodus 2:23, 24, and 25.
"And it came to pass in process of time that the king of Egypt died, and the children of Israel sighed by reason of the bondage, and they cried, and their cry came up unto God by reason of the bondage.
And God heard their groaning, and God remembered his covenant with Abraham, with Isaac, and with Jacob. And God looked upon the children of Israel, and God had respect unto them."
Hallelujah. Now they were singing, no more did they sigh, or weep, or groan in Egypt.
When you are a child of God, and begin to cry out Abba, don't you know that your Father will come to you, no matter what impossible trouble, or place, or relationship, or bondage, or situation you are in?
Call your Father in right away.
Don't hesitate until later. Later may be too late.
Activate your faith the very second you are confronted with impossible odds.
Don't let the adversary make you flee from him.
Believe that your Father,
in whom you trust,
he will come to see about your welfare.
We ought to sing and give to our Father in heaven
the praise and the worship. He is worthy of all praise.
From the fruit of our lips. Hebrews 13:15.
Through Jesus, therefore, let us continually offer to God a sacrifice of praise, the fruit of lips that confess his name.
Hosea 14:2.
Take words with you and return to the Lord.
Say to him, "Forgive all our sins and receive us graciously, that we may offer the fruit of our lips."
For when we were slaves in bondage in this world,
we were chained to sin
and sentenced to die that way,
and then to be judged by the word of God, and then afterwards to be sentenced to burn in a lake of eternal fire.
God sent one like Moses to free us from our bondage and then lead us to our Father in heaven.
God sent his only begotten Son, the word of God, to deliver us from the bondage of sin, which our mortal bodies are susceptible to.
Someday we will all stand and sing the song of Moses, because we are forgiven of our sins and delivered from eternal death. and damnation.
Revelations, chapter 15, verses 2 through 4.
And I saw what looked like a sea of glass mixed with fire.
And standing beside the sea,
those who had been victorious over the beast, and his image, and over the number of his name.
They held harps given them by God.
And sang the song of Moses the servant of God and the song of the Lamb. Great and marvelous are your deeds, Lord God Almighty, just and true are your ways, King of the ages. Who will not fear you, O Lord, and bring glory to your name? For you alone are holy. All nations will come and worship before you, for your righteous acts have been revealed.
Hallelujah.
We ought to sing.
Hallelujah.
In the millennium kingdom, when the kingdom of God will be formally established on the new earth, they will sing a song. Isaiah 12, verses 2 through 6.
Behold, God is my salvation, I will trust, and not be afraid, for the Lord Jehovah is my strength and my song, he also is become my salvation.
Therefore with joy shall ye draw water out of the wells of salvation.
And in that day shall ye say, Praise the Lord, call upon his name, declare his doings among the people, make mention that his name is exalted.
Sing unto the Lord, for he hath done excellent things, this is known in all the earth.
Cry out and shout, thou inhabitant of Zion, for great is the Holy One of Israel in the midst of thee.
The children of Israel sang,
after they were set free from 70 years of Babylonian captivity.
A portion of Psalm 118.
The Lord is my strength and song, and is become my salvation. The voice of rejoicing and salvation is in the tabernacles of the righteous. The right hand of the Lord doeth valiantly.
The right hand of the Lord is exalted. The right hand of the Lord doeth valiantly.
I shall not die, but live, and declare the works of the Lord.
The Lord hath chastened me sore, but he hath not given me over unto death.
Open to me the gates of righteousness. I will go into them, and I will praise the Lord.
This gate of the Lord, into which the righteous shall enter.
I will praise thee, for thou hast heard me, and art become my salvation.
This is the day which the Lord hath made, we will rejoice and be glad in it.
Thou art my God, and I will praise thee, thou art my God, I will exalt thee. O give thanks unto the Lord, for he is good, for his mercy endureth forever.
When your father does something good for you, because he saw your need, or he heard your cry, and met your need.
How do you respond? How should you respond? Do you respond at all? Are you humble and thankful, expressing happiness and making him promises that you intend to keep, hopefully?
As children of God, when our Father responds to our cries and pleas, we bow down before him and worship him, giving thanks for his mercy and salvation.
Then our soul begins to praise him, as our hearts leap for joy, and our spirit communes with his spirit. That is when we sing unto the Lord a new song.
Isaiah 42:10. Sing unto the Lord a new song, and his praise from the end of the earth, ye that go down to the sea, and all that is therein, the isles, and the inhabitants thereof.
Hallelujah.
We ought to sing. We ought to sing.
Hallelujah.
We ought to sing. He is worthy.
We ought to sing and give thanks.
We ought to sing, for his mercy endureth forever.
We ought to sing praises unto the Lord.
Hallelujah.
He is worthy.
His works are mighty.
Psalms 22:3. But you are holy, you who inhabit the praises of Israel. God is holy, and he inhabits the praises of his people. So when we can't seem to sense his holy presence with us, and within us, all that we have to do is begin to lift up our voice and praise the Lord our God in the beauty of his holiness, and the Lord shall inhabit our hearts with his holy presence.
Lift up your heads, O ye gates,
and be ye lift up, ye everlasting doors,
and the King of glory
shall come in.
Psalms 24:7.
Psalms 24:8. Who is this King of glory?
The Lord strong and mighty.
The Lord mighty in battle.
Psalms 24:9. Lift up your heads, O ye gates, even lift them up, ye everlasting doors, and the King of glory shall come in.
Psalms 24:10. Who is this King of glory?
The Lord of hosts.
He is the King of glory.
Selah.
Psalms 113, 1. Praise ye the Lord. Praise, O ye servants of the Lord. Praise the name of the Lord.
Ezra 3:11. And they sang together by course in praising and giving thanks unto the Lord, because he is good, for his mercy endureth forever toward Israel. And all the people shouted with a great shout, when they praised the Lord, because the foundation of the house of the Lord was laid.
We ought to sing, shout, worship, and praise the Lord, and dance like David, for his mercy, to his children, endures forever.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.